Then I suppose we can go. So basically this game here, I do the standard opening, like one Rex expand into two Rex Academy, and I just wanted to show you like what you should look for, what you should pay attention to, and so on. So let's skip a little bit forward to the first barracks. So basically, I don't know if you're familiar with the scouting timings. If you are on a four-player map, you usually scout after you build your barracks. But if you play on a two-player map, you can send a later scout because you know where your opponent is, and you just have to make sure that he doesn't open or that he doesn't have early links. And then you...
Does Afterex catch 9-4? Like, or is it too late for that?
Again, please?
If I scout after Rex, does it still like catch 9-pull and give me time to react?
Yes, if you double scout, if you don't find him at the first position.
Okay.
So here, if I play on a two-player map, I usually scout with the 13s or at 13 with a 12 SCV. Because that will still be in time to see early links, and you will scout early enough to be able to build your CC at 17 supply. And that's pretty optimal. And you don't have to... You could send an earlier scout like at 11 and then could save a depot, but you would have to skip the marine, and if you drone scouts, it will be annoying to save your SCV. So that's why I always do it like this. So here you can see my opponent then for 12 hatch and 2 hatch gas.
On 4 player map you said that you scout at a Rex, but you mean supply, right? Not...
No, on 4 player...
When you start Rex, you send it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah, after, yeah, otherwise it's just, way too late, yeah.
Yeah, very greedy. Yeah.
Yeah, after you, so basically at 11.5 you start scouting on 4 player maps.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
So, and then I see he has 2 hatcheries. Or vent hatch first, so I get my CC, and then I just build continuously SCVs. And then I build first the second depot, or the next depot, and then I build my racks because I don't want to stop SCV production or marine production. And what's also important is to check his lair timing. He went lair like around 3 minutes. That means he does not get link speed first. That's important to know for your bunker timing in case he goes for some kind of all-in. And after you place down your second barracks, you get your refinery and then academy when you have the money, but you never stop SCV production.
Is there a latest time where you need to put down your academy? I guess so you have your scan ready in case you haven't
scouted. I think it would be at 4 minutes. Because you should build your scanners at 5 minutes.
Okay.
I'm not sure how long the academy builds. But
yeah,
at 5 minutes you should start your eBay and your scanners to be in time.
Yeah.
Yes, and also you should check with your SCV if you can how many links he's building. Usually if he chases your SCV with just the links he initially built, then he doesn't have any more links. Usually Zergs want to get rid of the scout first before they attack you. In some cases it might be that they went for like initial 6 links, and in that case they usually just chase your SCV with 1 link And that should trigger in your mind that you should prepare for like six links or seven links in your at your natural, because he also has a lava at your at his natural, and you have to pull some SCVs to defend that.
Yep.
Also, regarding just the general timings with the gas in the academy, when your refinery finishes, you should usually be able to build your academy, and it's a perfect time to do that in this time, because you will then have enough gas for your two commsat stations, for stim and two medics. And then that's all the gas you accumulated up to this point. So other than that, there's nothing unusual going on. After the academy, you then get your eBay. And in this case, you see that my opponent went as greedy as possible. He only built two links and just builds drones. And because I see that, I know I don't need a bunker. Otherwise, I would build a bunker right about now, because I lost my SCV. But I know he wouldn't be able, even if he would pump now non-stop links, he wouldn't be able to kill me or bust my natural.
Regarding the bunker placement, would the bunker then go above the depot, I guess, probably?
No, I would put probably it in down. Between the depot and the command center.
Okay, also makes sense, yeah.
So that you can block as much pathway as possible.
Yeah.
What you also... yeah, go ahead.
Then makes sense.
Okay. What I also wanted to say is, if you see that he didn't build any links early game, you know that he has a third hatchery by the time his muter will start building. After you build your eBay and your scanners, when you build your scanners, you don't build SCVs during that time, so you can build the third rack before you build an additional depot. You will see that I'm just starting to build a depot right now on my main, but I'm pretty close to my supply limit. But I can do that because I didn't build SCVs because the scanners were building. And also, it's just before the time that you have to build turrets anyway for the muters. So basically my or the build is supposed to go like this. I build the scanners as late as possible, at like a little bit after 5 minutes is the latest. Then you have scanners ready at before 5:30, which is when he starts building muters or lurkers, depending on what he's doing. And I'm trying here to move out to force some sunkens, but he threatens a small run-by, that's why I'm not committing. And I'm starting here to build turrets, because I know the usual timing, and I think I did not scan yet. But you usually should. But because I saw the building spire with my SCVs, I think I just did not scan. Yeah, I still have energy. And at the time when he is building, or when he starts to build muters, build turrets at your main, at your natural first, like 2 or 3 turrets, because there's almost always a cliff, so it's harder to defend with medic marine. And you build at least one turret at your production facilities and one turret at the main. And depending on how he's committing to the muters, you should add additional turrets. So here I'm moving out because I know that he doesn't have any more links, because he built only drones except for the 4 links which got killed. So I can move out with my initial marines just to prevent from him sniping some SCVs.
I have a question.
Yes.
Do you usually build just three barracks before you go factory, right?
Yes, or that's like my standard.
Standard.
Yeah.
And if you build more, then you just committed to some attack.
If you build more,
don't have enough resources.
Repeat, please.
Or you just don't have enough resources to produce from four barracks at this point.
You can build four barracks, but then your attack is later, and I prefer to have a fast attack, and I am not as committed to killing his third base.
Mm-hmm. I see. Okay.
And also, if you want to really have fast four barracks, you usually don't get plus one fast. And with like the standard build, you can go, you research Stim, and then when your eBay finishes, you can start plus one immediately as soon as you have 100 gas. Your range will then be a little bit later because you don't have a gas, but it is worth it to delay it a little bit to have a significantly earlier start of plus one attack.
So three barracks are optimal, I see.
It's the default optimal
for faster attack.
Yes, yes. Three barracks is safe enough versus mutas, versus 2H mutas usually, and then you can just tag. And if you have good micro, a good awareness, then you can also kill the third or severely harm the Zerg. And what you should also do is periodically you should just reinforce your medic marine so that they don't get wiped out. So now I'm just only now scanning, and I check usually the third and the natural, because in the at the natural you see what he's building and how his drone saturation is. That is also true for when you usually use your first scan at all. You should use it at the natural because you can determine a lot of stuff just from looking at it. The amount of drones tells you how many links he has outside your base. So if there is a drone at every mineral field and the gas is saturated, he doesn't have a lot of links, like six or something. And if he has three lavas or three eggs are building right now, it is very likely to be mutas, simply because if he would go lurkers, he would have already built the hydras. He needs to morph them into lurkers. So these are strong indicators to determine what the Zerg has. You don't even need to necessarily see the tech building.
Droncon seems to be red alone, right? Or it feels red alone.
Yes, because he transferred some drones to his third to get more gas.
Oh yeah.
I can let me rewind a little bit to the actual timing where you should scan. Like 5:30. And you can see he has six drones on minerals, which is fine. Yeah. I think he has a little bit more. Because he already takes the hatchery, yes. Okay, so and because of that, you know he does have only like six links or something. Okay, so and basically, you don't even have to push out too far because you don't want to lose your medic marine. You can just collect your medic marine at the front of your natural, because you know he doesn't have, or he does have a third and he wants to keep it, and he knows that you know that he has a third, and that's why he rather tries to attack your medic marine boy usually instead of just going into your main. That's why you don't need to add more turrets. And it is enough to just stay outside your natural and keep collecting your medic marine, because it takes a while until he gets lurkers, which you should periodically scan to see if he's taking to it or if he's going muta all in. If he goes just muta all in, or just produce mutas, you don't need to immediately go and wipe an all. You can wait until your plus one is done and then go. Yes, also regarding the build, if you when you start your factory, you should also start your gas to have enough gas vent for tanks and science vessels. I usually go for tanks and vessels if the Zerg goes for lurkers. If he only goes for mutas and wants to take two ultras immediately, I usually don't get tanks at all and get double starport and then macro on two base quite a bit.
Yeah, tanks are just nice to clean out ultras.
The problem is if he doesn't get lurkers, his ultra tech is usually too fast for you to be able to bust him. That's why I don't do it anymore. I just go 8 barracks, 2 starport on 2 base with upgrades and wait. If I wasn't able to bust his third or something, I wait until I have plus 2 and then I try to kill him.
I have a question. What do you think about, because I'm doing it sometimes, if I see that Zerg is scoring Mass Muta for a little bit of time, I'm trying to add a Valkyrie because I can get it a bit faster than the vessel and take it to my Marine Medic Ball and just push him with, because he can't engage really M&M's plus a Valkyrie with only Mutas.
You can do that. It's a viable reaction.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, so here I got a bit lucky in this game because he missed my move out to his third. You can see his mutas are searching for me at the top of the map, and there I managed to get decent damage. Also, what I wanted to tell you regarding micro, there's always this problem that you have to macro and you have to micro versus his mutas. A good thing to do is never stand near cliffs so that you can always see the mutas engaging, and when he engages you, you want to target fire singular or individual mutalists so that they die as fast as possible, basically. And if you want to, and at some point you have to macro or build some supply depots, build your factory or whatnot, it is a good strategy or tactic to just A move on a single mutalisk, and during that time you go back and build your stuff, because he will usually hear the stim and see that the marines are running to his mutalisk and just run away, and you have enough time to get stuff done without your marines dying. And then you go back to marines and ball them together again and maybe reinforce and stuff like that. With that you can be relatively efficient on open map versus mutas.
So do you macro when you build marines, do you go to the base with F4 or something, or do you
hotkey the... But it is not the optimal way. Better would be if you would be able to like hotkey your 3 barracks and just continuously produce there. But I just am accustomed to doing it that way, and since you always or almost always have to build stuff anyways, you always have to get back to the base, or almost always have to get to the base, so it isn't that much of a difference, but it would be better to do it with hotkeys.
But I guess it's mostly a preference, it feels like.
For me, it's hard to relearn.
Yeah, exactly.
Some advice: if you have not that bad micro with the marines and it's early game, it's not like 50 M&Ms, so you have one group or something, and fighting early mutas, you can put the marine a little bit outside of your ball, because it's just a bait. The Zerg player wants to snipe it at the first, and if you waiting for it, you just
running back with that marine, so we're flying with the mutas in all your marine ball. But it's not for beginners.
Yeah, it's advanced stuff, yeah.
Why do you have only two medics? Is it enough?
Well, for the first push out, yes.
I think it was like a free
to feel like
yeah, I think I lost one to a snipe from the mutalisk. Yeah. But I usually, when my third barracks finishes, I build a third medic. And then occasionally I build another like every second round or so. So that you have a good ratio. So yeah, so here I basically get a good advantage because I can fight very efficiently, and he lost like drones and also mutas, which he doesn't want to. So basically I think I'm just staying home for now, and I'm just tacking and waiting until my push is ready with tanks and vessel.
So do you go like as soon as your vessel is done, or?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes I go earlier when I see he doesn't have lurkers yet. Depends on different stuff that's happening in the game. And also what I recommend is to snipe this overlord at your natural at some point, simply because he will always know when you move out, and it's a really, really huge advantage for the Zerg that he knows where your army is. You should always try to have your medic marine ball when you move out. Don't camp it near a cliff. Generally because of mutas, but also because of the overlords. If he knows where your stuff is, he can counter-attack because he sees you don't move.
Yeah. So many Zergs do Dan plus Queen's Nest at, say, 7 minutes or a little later.
Yes, yes.
Do you still go for a tank push then? Or
usually, like, yes, because I'm simply trying to still put pressure on, but you're right, it should usually not work then. Or you would go for an earlier tank timing, like with two tanks only, because if he goes for such an early Queen's Nest, maybe he has sometimes no lurkers yet. Depends really.
Yeah.
So, and here I'm also trying to go for a max switch then afterwards, but it doesn't matter too much in this game, and it's also hard to pull off. I struggle myself a lot. It's just something I wanted to relearn versus 2-edge muta, because it's really hard to do it versus this opening. The like standard way is to just put down more barracks and stay on medic marine. And when you have like a third gas, you can also start just building tanks for defense, and use your medic marine to try to deny further expansions. I think in this game there's not too much going on anymore, because he didn't tech to Hive yet, because his third was severely like damaged. I basically just have a big advantage. You can see at the worker count that I have like twice the workers. But in general, just for the pushing advice, you should scan ahead when you push with tanks, just to see where his lurker or his army in general is, so that you know when to siege, and then just siege down his natural when you are there. Yeah, that's basically it. I think there's nothing else going on here. Okay. Okay, yeah, that would be one game.
GG.
Yeah, GG, thanks. I would have another one, which is more of a cheesy one from the Zerg side. Where so this opponent here was like S, and the other one is maybe also S, but at least A. And he went for a cheesier build, 9 pool fast lair into 1 hedge lurker. And I just wanted to show you the reaction I did.
Is it Oxer?
No, no. I don't know. Maybe it was a. It was a Smurf account.
Okay. He does a lot of one base builds.
He was really good because I struggled in that game. So, but. It's a nice example because you don't see that very often in at higher levels that someone goes one hedge lurker. Shiva Taran, are you joining?
Sorry, I was in the bathroom.
Can you just make extra highlights?
Oh yeah, sure. Also the build for the One Rex Expand you can find in this Terran Builds channel. I posted the build on replay there. So in this game I basically open the same way with like 9 depot, 11 Rex, 13 Scout. And then I see his slings and his fast lair. So I switch up to one base build to 2 Rex Academy. And what you should always do versus 9 pool, block your ramp with like 4 or 5 SCVs.
Yeah.
And then you're safe. If a Zerg engages like this and he lost some Zerglings, you can usually get some SCVs back from the ramp and block it with just 1 or 2 because there's no need to waste the economy. And for the 2 Rex Academy build, you usually, or you should get your Academy like similar timing again if when your refinery finishes, get your Academy, and for this you have to shortly cut SCVs, so in order to be able to afford it, and then just build your depot and then you can continue SCV production. So he is going Lurkers. I think I saw it when I, let me rewind. Not sure. No, I think. Oh yeah, he killed it before. Yeah, I didn't see it, but I anticipated it. Simply because it's like the most viable build of one hedge layer. And also, because you are doing a one base build, you still have early enough Medic Marine that you can move out before his tech is done. As you can see here, I should scan in a little bit to see what he's up to. And in this game I'm lucky because he didn't hide his hydroliths, and I see that his locker are here, so I can just camp his natural and I'm safe. And don't have to be afraid of any lurker busts at my natural. If you don't see the lurkers at his base, you should really consider continuing to push. You can see that I also build a safety bunker at my ramp in case there's like a counterattack.
Yeah, mostly they just take one, two hydras, maybe here near your third, and pop the lurker eggs there.
Yes. Because usually people who play one hatch lurker, they want to all in you, but this guy didn't. He really like and planned for a follow-up. As you can see, he only built the initial four lurkers and then immediately started to build a spire. And I'm on the other hand, I'm simply just hacking now, because you might think, okay, I am behind in economy, but it's not significantly, I would say, because I have more SCVs than he has drones, and the only advantage that he has is that he is more efficient because he has two mineral lines. But you have to be careful with this kind of stuff, because you went lurkers, you usually save your scanners to be able to react to that. But when you have like 100 energy, you should use it to scan if he has, or if he switched tech and does something else.
Hey guys.
Hello. And I scanned him here and I saw the mutas flying to the bottom right and also the spire. So I start building turrets.
Guys also participating in King of the Tears?
I'm not.
Hey.
So, and on the one base play, because he went for mutas now, I prioritize getting a vessel with irradiate. If he would only build lurkers, you can just only build the vessel without irradiate, just to have a detection and get tanks and siege mode. The Zerg here caught me in with a good angle and was able to do some damage. And you should be simply trying to just hold until you have a vessel with irradiate. I also try to hold the front because I don't want him to expand. Maybe it's not the best play because at some point he will be able to snipe it with enough units. But he mainly goes for harassment.
Yeah, he could crush your army in this natural with the lurkers and the mutas.
Yes, you of course have to be aware of that, yeah. Maybe it would actually be better at this point to simply retreat. Because he's doing some significant damage in my base. But what you should also not neglect when you're going one base, you should use the eBay you have and get the upgrades, because he doesn't have any upgrades for his ground army. So over short or long, you will have a huge advantage. Okay, and I see that he continues to build mutas, so I build more turrets. And now he cleared my... Yeah. Here I wasn't very careful, I don't know if you caught it, but he managed to kill my Medic Marine pretty efficiently because I didn't look at the minimap at the correct time.
How come you're stuck on one base? Or is it just fun marketing? You were stuck on one.
Yeah, because I decided to. Because of a one hatch locker, I decided not to get an expansion.
Windshack.
And it is more important for me to tag when rather than expand, because if I do that and he goes for this muter switch, for example, I really am in a bad spot, because he can just mass muters, and until I have tech, it's gonna be a long time. So our economy is still somewhat even.
I would say Terran's ahead in this awkward scenario.
Well, because of a tech advantage, yes, but I don't really get much more money than Berserk. And he He also managed to clean up my front Medic Marine without good value from my side. And here I do a bit of a mistake, I think, because I move out for some reason, being afraid that my natural gets busted, basically, even though I don't have one, and lose my tanks basically for free. And I should just wait until I'm ready and have medics with my medic marine.
Quick mute. Quick mute. Das
blöd. Yeah. And because I just lost my army, I knew, okay, I can't move out or take my natural, so I just build additional barracks to really mass up, because I still know that his economy is still not good and he doesn't have any tech. I think I scouted, I scanned him at some point again, or not. I should. And I'm simply messing up, and I guess he also gets a little bit impatient, because he tries to deny my natural, which I don't have, basically. And I can just slow push down the ramp and kill his lurkers. And you can see my plus one marines are now really strong, plus irradiate, so his muters are much less effective.
It's really much money, this guy?
Yeah, he doesn't have... He should build additional hatcheries and to build links. And here he just desperately tries to deny me from moving out, but fails, and then he GGs. And it's a somewhat reasonable GG, because he didn't have any military units after that. But maybe he could have... Yeah, well, maybe not, because I did have tanks, so lurkers wouldn't have helped him.
He should need to go back, pump some links, get a new expansion or something, but he was too greedy, he wanted to kill you, I think, or deny your expansion least, of any cost, yeah.
Yeah. Alrighty, that's basically the two games I had prepared. If you have questions or other suggestions, or you want to show a replay of your own, feel free.
Yes, a question on that previous game. Is there any option to go after your 2-Rex Academy push, and you saw that he didn't go all in, he instead went for expand. You just continued on one base trying to mess up one big army. Would you say that that is in general the best option, to stay at one base instead of trying to expand yourself and go into a more standard?
If he goes for something like one hatch layer, nine pool layer, then yes, because it is... He can safely take his natural with like a couple of lurkers, and if you and then tech to muters, and then it's basically the same like scenario as if you would have run Rex expanded, but you have less money. He also has less money, but I think that the timing is the tech timing for his is. For him is so fast that you really struggle to take your natural, because he you should have the muters before your command center at the naturalist even done, I think. Well, the command center is done, but you wouldn't have stim. And you would have to build a lot of turrets, I think. It's a long time ago since I played versus 9 pull layer. Also intermutas, because that's also a threat. Sometimes there are people who go 9 pull layer into mutas, and then you will have a really bad time. You probably would have to cut SCVs until you built your academy after you started your CC to be able to have tech in time or turrets even in time. Yeah, because you would have to get your eBay at like 4 minutes. And we can take a look if I start the first replay again. Where I go with standard, it's also wrong. But let's do it anyway for some kind of comparison. Because versus 9 pool, you would have to block your ramp first, lose mining time there, would get your CC a little bit later, and then you would have to get your gas immediately, academy immediately, eBay immediately.
And can someone stream it? Because then I can do my hotkeys next to it and don't need to be in a match myself. So I can do things.
Well, because I can just start and look at the timer, because that's really the only thing that interests me.
Okay.
Because with 9 pool layer, he would have muters ready at like 5 minutes.
Yeah, but I was just curious because it kind of feels like a bad build. Because I mean, it's kind of just he shoots himself in the foot economically, and then just plays a macro game out of that. Or I don't know. I mean, I guess he has pressure, but I don't know. Just doesn't seem like a great build for the server.
Yeah, of course, it's just to catch people off guard who don't know how to handle it. Otherwise, he would play standard. So if I'm here like at 4 minutes, and yeah, you would have to sacrifice. I don't even know if it would be possible. You probably would have to get the refinery, academy, and eBay on one barracks, and then you would be able to hold any of the fast tech builds of 9 pool layer. But that I would have to check in single player to see how the build works out.
Yeah.
Replays.
Yeah, okay.
I mean I have replays with a lot of good ones. And I wouldn't know which one is which. I don't know. Should start naming them if they are interesting. I never do that for some reason.
Well, I almost never do that either. Oh, except for like the really close ones. I name them, but yeah. They are very rare.
Mine are not close most of the time. Most of the time it's me running Marines into Lurkers or something along those lines.
Oh yeah, you shouldn't do that. You should well, it's of course a lot of experience, but you should just scan his main and see if he has a Hydra gen, and if he does, he probably has Lurkers.
Yeah, I mean I know he has Lurkers, I just my Marines get pulled by something and they just walk into it.
Ah, I see.
I mean I can, because I forgot hold position. Hold position.
Yeah, you should always do that if you go back to macro or something like that. And there are Lurkers, you should always hold position.
I'm still getting used to like putting my Marines on hold and then after that my medics on to stop so they still do their job. Because I mean otherwise the medics just stand around if my stuff gets attacked and that's not
good. Yeah. Alrighty. So if there are no questions, I guess we could end, except if you want to know some general things.
I'll see if I can find some replays and then I'll put them into the Terran strategy journal. Mm-hmm. But I need to go through my like autosave folder for that. That's gonna take some time.
Yeah.
But for now, I'm just gonna sit down and redo the hotkeys and then go into single player and hit them forward and try to get them feeling somewhat decent. Well, have a good evening, guys, and thanks. And see you.
Alrighty.
Thanks a lot for the session. It was good. And I'll probably find some good replays and post it in.
Yeah, do that. Then I will take a look. And
yeah, because I didn't really find any good one now that I want to check. So
yeah, all right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Then thanks for coming.
Thanks a lot.
And then have a nice evening.
You too.
Okay, bye. Goodbye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.